Hi everyone, this is Ritu from Textifier. Welcome to the third part of web automation testing using Selenium and Python. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with alerts. Testing an application is a tedious task. To make it effective and easy, we need to handle all the alerts which pop up during the execution of the task. So this lecture is all about handling different alerts and pop-ups. Let's start with the alerts. Alerts are basically the pop-up boxes that takes your focus away from the current window and force you to read the alert messages. They are treated as on-screen message box to give the user some information or sometime ask him to perform some kind of operation. For example, a user wants to delete some record. It asks the user for confirmation, "Are you sure to delete the record?" These type of things appearing on a web page are known as alerts. They may also be used for warning purpose. For example, when I try to click on the sign in button without entering the username and password, this pop-up will appear. This is a alert box with warning, "Please enter a valid username." This is a JavaScript alert. These alerts are defined by the developer. Until we handle this alert, we are unable to click anywhere on the screen. We are unable to access any other element. So to move further with the testing, we need to handle this alert first. These are few types of alerts. They are basically simple alert, confirmation alert, and prompt alert. Simple alert is used to display some information or warning message on screen. This is a simple alert. It comes with only one option, that is OK. Next is confirmation alert. Confirmation alert comes with the option of OK and cancel. User have option to accept or dismiss the alert. Next is prompt alert. Prompt alert asks for the input from the user. Dot send key method is used to type something in this prompt box, in this text box. These are the example of JavaScript alert. If we click any of this button, this alert will appear here. In testing to automate this alert, when we try to inspect this box, we are unable to inspect it. So what we have to do, we need to switch the driver to this alert first. Until we don't make a switch to this alert, the driver will remain on this parent window. So to handle, we need to switch to this alert. So let's start handling the alert. This is our code. In the very beginning, I have imported the web driver and the time module. Here is the path for the Chrome web driver. And this is the URL of the website where we want to navigate. This is the URL for this website. Now to start with testing, first we need to locate this first button of the simple alert. We will locate this button by right clicking over here, going to inspect, and we'll pick his ID from here and use it in our code. We locate this element by using this command driver.findElementById and performing the click operation over it. Once we click on this alert box appears. This is a simple alert. By clicking on OK, we simply means accepting this alert. So to accept this alert, we use the command driver.switchToAlert. What we are doing with this command, we are switching the driver to that alert. And we are assigning the reference of this alert to this variable sAlert. It is a variable, its name can be anything. I have selected sAlert. And now to accept this alert, we use the command dot accept by using the reference of the alert and dot accept command. Also, I will introduce some time slip so that we will see the execution clearly. Now I'm going to run the program. We have navigated to the website. Now it has switched to that alert and will accept it. In the similar way, we will proceed with the confirmation alert window. First, we'll locate this button using its ID. If you don't know how to locate any element on a web page, you can refer to the first part of the series of web automation testing videos. Once we click on this button, this confirmation alert window has appeared. It comes with two options of OK and cancel. If we want to click on OK, we will simply accept this alert by using dot accept method. And if we want to click on the cancel, we will use dot dismiss method. Let's see in our code. This is the code for confirmation alert window. In the very first line, I have located that confirmation box button and will perform click operation. In the second line, I have switched to the alert and assigning its reference to this variable C alert. Here, I am accepting this alert. If I want to click on OK, I will use this command dot accept. And if I want to cancel the alert, I will use dot dismiss. For this example, I will go with dot dismiss method because in the first example of simple alert, I have used dot dismiss, sorry, dot accept. For this, I'm going with dot dismiss method. So now our next alert window is prompt box. Similarly, we will locate this button and we'll click on this button. This prompt box will appear with some text area. It asks user what is your city name, and user have to enter some text in this text area, and then it will accept this alert. Now we will see this its code. This is the code for the third alert box. In this line, we have located the third button and performed the click operation over it. In the next line, we have switched the driver to that alert and assigning its reference to the variable P alert. And in this alert, alert is asking for your city name. So I want to send my city name as Panchkula. For testing point of view, sometimes we need to verify that text in the alert box is coming as per our requirement or not. For that, if we want to print the text, which is printed in the text, in the alert window, we will use dot text method like this. Print reference of the alert dot text. It will print that text appearing on that alert window on this terminal. And next, if I want to accept the alert, I will go with this accept method. And if I don't want to use the dismiss, I will comment it out. Introduce some time sleep. And finally, after performing all the tasks of the testing, I will quit the driver. Now I will run the program to see the final output. We'll see the driver will switch to the different alert windows one by one and also perform operation over it. First, now it will switch to the second alert window. And we'll click on, as we click on the cancel button, it shows a message deletion aborted. Now the third window, it accept this window and we have entered the test Panchkula. And also the text in the alert window is printed here. So that's all for the alerts. This is how we can work with the alerts window by using two different commands. First is driver.switch to alert, and second is .accept and .dismiss method. If you want to accept any alert, we will go with .accept, and if you want to cancel the alert, we'll use .dismiss method. So that's all for today's lecture of handling alerts and pop-ups. This lecture has everything you need to know about the alerts. In the next lecture, we will discuss how we can automate date pickers or calendars in Selenium. Till then, if you have any query regarding web automation testing, just leave your query in the comment section. Thanks for watching the video.